Good evening. There's been a dangerous escalation of Melbourne's bikie war tonight, with an innocent mother and boy caught up in the violence. They were carjacked by a gunman moments after a man was shot while leaving a funeral at Fawkner Cemetery.
Clipping a truck, a gunman loses control and crashes his getaway car into a fire hydrant and a traffic light in a mad scramble to flee a daytime ambush. He just shot a former Mongol's bikie several times as Sam Abdul Rahim drove away from a funeral in Fawkner. As water gushes into the air, the gunman and his mate run across the road just as the critically injured victim drives through the same intersection in his black Mercedes on his way to the nearby Fawkner police station to get help. But the gunman's crime spree wasn't done. His next target, carjacking a woman and a boy, stealing their Ford Territory. His passenger opted to flee on foot.
I'm not certain about how many firearms were used in the shooting. As I understand, firearms were produced in the carjacking, but as I say, the mother and her son were not injured, but obviously it was a terrifying experience.
Sam Abdul Rahim made it to the car park of the Fawkner police station. Bullet holes in the driver's window and windscreen. The former bikie turned boxer was shot several times in the stomach and upper body. Two other men in his car were not injured.
We came out, we saw the van stop there, and a couple of guys getting out of the van, they weren't looking too good. One in particular was holding his side. They were rushing to kind of address the situation as it stood there at the moment, so they weren't doing any arrests or anything like that. It seemed to be to take care of what the situation was at that time.
Just cops everywhere. There was, when first happened, there was helicopters everywhere.
7 News understands Sam Abdul Rahim was a member of the Mongols' outlaw motorcycle gang before being kicked out of the club alongside Toby Mitchell and Corey Kasichi, who was murdered in May. He was also jailed for 2 years in 2017 after a fatal crash which killed an 88-year-old great-grandmother and was at the centre of a wild brawl inside the Melbourne Magistrates Court in 2015. Cassie Zervos, 7 News.